I am Anant R. Shastri, retired Emeritus Fellow, Department of Mathematics, IIT Bombay. I am going to present this course on algebraic topology, part 1, under this NPTEL portal. My team members are Dr. B. Subhash, ICER Tirupati, Dr. K. Ramesh, IITM, Vidhan Paul, Shiva Shankar, Vinay Sipani, all from IITM. This course is presented in 62 modules of approximately 30 minutes each in a span of 12 weeks. Along with these slides and lectures, there will be a number of live sessions for doubt clearing sessions. The content of the lectures can be divided into these 7 chapters, you may call: introduction, fundamental group, function-space topology, relative homotopy, simplicial complexes part 1, simplicial complex part 2, and covering space and fundamental group, and covering space and G coverings and fundamental group. I will be assuming that the student of this course is well acquainted with the rudiments of point set topology. Also, this course is at the level MSc. Therefore, a certain amount of mathematical maturity will be presumed. We have strived hard to bring this advanced subject to your door by giving some completely elementary treatment to this one, and also explaining beyond all written textbooks. The one good reference for this material is my own book on basic algebraic topology. However, I will give you, along with all the material in this cover, in the PDF format, in which there will be further references for further study. As far as the present course is concerned, the duration of the present course, you can stick to those notes which will be available on the NPTEL website. Okay. So, let us come to what is meaning of basic problem in topology. Central problem in topology is to determine if two given topological spaces are homeomorphic or not. For instance, hope you all know that any two open intervals in R are homeomorphic to each other. Since we can actually write down a homeomorphism in each case, give me any two intervals AB and CD, you can actually write down a linear homeomorphism which sends A to C and B to D. Okay, and then you can also write a homeomorphism from open interval AB to the entire of the real line. Okay, so this will take care of most of the cases, but then you can study other cases also. By actually writing down homeomorphism, no problem, right? So, on the other hand, we also know that a closed interval and open interval are not homeomorphic to each other because one is, the closed interval is compact, whereas the other one is not compact. So, compactness, which is a topological invariant, is good enough to distinguish between an open interval and a closed interval. There may be other methods, don't worry. So it's one method. But we have been able to tell that a closed interval and an open interval are not homeomorphic. Okay. In general, displaying a homeomorphism between topological spaces becomes very difficult. It's not like just intervals case. On the other hand, it is fruitful and easier to find out that there is no homeomorphism between two given spaces, X and Y, if that is the case. The standard method is to look for a suitable topological invariants, such as compactness, connectedness, etc. Okay, so these things you must have seen in topology course. Just I am recalling to motivate what I am going to do in this course. So let us take another example of how one is using connectivity. An example, very simple example, namely, let us look at R and R cross R, which is R2, the real line and the plane. These are not homeomorphic. Okay. So how do you proceed? Suppose there is a homeomorphism. Say, let us call it F from R2, R2. Throw away the zero from the origin. Throw away the image of zero from the domain R2. Whatever is left out, F takes R minus 0 to R2 minus F0. And that itself will be a 1-1 map, onto map, continuous, inverse is also continuous. So it's a homeomorphism. Any restriction to the corresponding subsets is also homeomorphism, right? Now what is happening? The domain of F is not connected, whereas the range is connected. You must be knowing that if you throw away a single point from R2, it is still connected. Whereas any single prompt from R, you throw away one single point, it is disconnected. Therefore, right in the beginning, there could not have been any function F which is homeomorphic from R to R2. Okay. Again, this method may not work very far. I have used connectivity, I have used compactness and so on, but you can go on using a number of them. There are situations wherein none of these things, the so-called topological invariants may fail to distinguish between two spaces. Such a thing can happen. Okay, let us just think about, say, suppose Rn and Rm, don't have to go too far, where n and m are just arbitrary. Say, m is bigger than n. Can you say that Rn and Rm are not homeomorphic? No simple point set topological fact will be able to tell you this. You know, just connectivity, etc., will not be enough. You may succeed to do something with R2 or something, but again, R3, R4, R5, etc., it will not work. However, very deep topological results are there. Dimension theory will tell you that Rn and Rm are not homeomorphic. Okay, so there are, but they are quite demanding, even inside point set topology. They are not easy. Okay. The role of algebraic topology is now, okay, it is good to have at least some idea what the fundamental problems in discipline are. Whenever you want to study some discipline, you must know what is it about. In most cases, these problems remain unsolved. Or you will know that someday that the problem is too difficult or problem is just unsolvable. even then, the concept of the central problem or the fundamental problem has so much of role to play, namely that there will be always some related problems or modified problems which will demand our attention. And this is the case with topology also in general and algebraic topology also in particular. Central objects of study in topology in the mainstream mathematics are not just topological spaces, it's too large, but let us take what are called as manifolds. These manifolds are something like modeled on Rn. Rn and Rm I am discussing. So they are locally in a small neighborhood, they look like Rn and Rm. Okay. Their rigorous definition will be introduced much later. The problem is then to determine whether two manifolds are homeomorphic or not. Don't worry about arbitrary spaces. Even this problem is known to be unsolvable. Okay. So, I want to tell you, the algebraic topology is associated with certain algebraic objects such as groups and rings, rather than compactness, separability, etc., which are more qualitative. Okay. The algebraic invariants that we are going to introduce, they are much more flexible than homeomorphism invariants. Obviously, these invariants will become additional tools for us while distinguishing two topological spaces. So I told you the classification problem means what? Determining whether two given spaces are homeomorphic or not. Up to homeomorphism, we are putting them in different classes. This has known to be unsolvable. The negative result itself has some implications for us. It's useful for us. So let us take a few minutes to look at how it was established. So this is where already algebraic topology comes into picture, not point set topology. Each path connected space X, one associates a group called the fundamental group. We are going to study this fundamental group very rigorously in this course. Okay. So right now you take it for granted. What we have done? Take a topological space which is path connected. You get a group out of it. This association has the property that if you have a function from X to Y, then there will be homomorphism from the group pi 1 of x to pi 1 of y. The association is so natural that if another map from y to z is there, okay, then you have two maps, f check and g check, which are group homomorphisms. The g composite f check, that means you first composite g and f and then take the associated map. That is nothing but the composite of the corresponding associated maps to begin with, G check, F check. Moreover, if you take the identity map from X to X, the associated map will be the identity homomorphism from pi 1 of X to pi 1 of X. Okay. So all this machinery is very, very fundamental in the construction of this, the fundamental group. And that is what part of algebraic topology, essence of algebraic topology. Okay. So the point is, once you have such a association, if F is homeomorphism, then F check becomes an isomorphism. Why? Because look at an inverse to G. F composite G is identity. Therefore, G check composite F check will be identity. So this way G check becomes inverse of F check as a homomorphism. So a homeomorphism induces an isomorphism. It just means that If you started the two spaces which are homeomorphic, the corresponding groups must be isomorphic. Therefore, if for some reason I know that the groups are not isomorphic, then you know that the corresponding spaces are not homeomorphic. Okay. So now, how does one use this to show that the classification problem itself is unsolvable? By showing that the corresponding classification in group theory is not solvable. Okay. So that itself is a huge thing. Even a restricted problem in group theory, namely what are called as finitely generated groups with finitely many relations, they are called finitely presented groups. Suppose I have given you a set of relations, set of generators, and set of relations that would describe a group. On the other hand, another set of generators, another set of relations that will identify another group. The word problem is that to determine whether these two groups are isomorphic or not. It is known that this word problem cannot be solved in general. What is the meaning of that? Suppose you write an algorithm to solve such a thing. As soon as you display your algorithm, we can give a set of examples, namely two such groups, which cannot be determined by this algorithm. The isomorphism between that, whether the two are isomorphic or not, cannot be solved. So this is the meaning of the word problem in group theory cannot be solved. A consequence of this is the homeomorphism problem for manifolds cannot be solved. There is a small gap here, namely, how does one go back to homeomorphisms? By constructing manifolds of take any particular group, then construct a manifold with that as fundamental group. Okay. So these problems are all problems in algebraic topology, not general topology. And unfortunately, we will not go this much deep in this course. So this is only a trailer for you to study more and more algebraic topology. So this problem in group theory was solved by a topologist, P.S. Noyakov, in 1955. This, however, does not close the subject altogether. Topology is still a very lively subject, extending a helping hand in solving problems in various areas of mathematics. Process such as associating the fundamental group to a space X, as considered above, is called constructing a functor. Algebraic topology may be described as, at the outset, study of such processes. In this course, we shall construct and study one most important functor called the fundamental group, and we will have a number of applications. Coming back to the fundamental problem, there are many interesting related problems other than the central one. For example, you want to find homeomorphism from one space to another space. Before that, you would have to find some nice functions. Okay, as a part of finding a homeomorphism, a function from some nice function which is continuous, or maybe a little more properties, open mapping, and so on. Okay, so instead of listing all these problems, I will list here, take up two central problems again within this one. Okay, just two basic ones. So they are like called, one is called the lifting problem, other one is called extension problem. underlying themes in these two problems occurs repeatedly in the study of basic notions of algebraic topology. So let us get familiar with these concepts slowly. So start with a triangle of functions. X, Y, Z are sets. F, G, and H are functions. What is the meaning of this triangle is commutative? Look at starting from X, you can go to Y and then come to Z. The arrows indicate where to go from where. Okay? The arrow is a function, right? So X to Y, Y to Z. But you can start directly come from X to Z. These two functions must be the same, namely G composite F must be H. That is the meaning of a diagram like this is commutative. You will have lots of such diagrams, not necessarily triangles. You may have rectangles, you may have pentagons and so on. Okay. In particular, if X, Y, Z are topological spaces and F and G, H are continuous functions, then you would like to have maps. But commutativity is just a set theoretic notion. G composite F must be H. Okay. Such a diagram is called commutative diagram. Given two of the three maps, the question is, can we consider the problem of finding one or all maps which fit the third arrow? So this is a general problem. Okay. If FG are given, then H can be taken to be G composite F. There is no other choice. But suppose H is given and F is given, then G could be many other possibilities. Similarly, if H is given and G is given, there may be many possibilities for F. There may not be any possibilities for F. This is the problem that I want to attack now. Okay. So let us make accordingly, let us make two different cases. The first case is, now I am going to give specific names here so that we remember it again and again. Instead of X, Y, Z, now I will take X, E, and B. E to B, there is a function P, there is a map. Okay, and the concentration is on this map. Given any function X to B, that is F, can you find a function G such that P composite G is equal to F? This is called the lifting problem, F being lifted to G via or through P. P composite G must be F. So the question is on this dotted line, other things are data. Does G exist? Is a question. That's why I have put it in the dotted line. Understand that one? Okay. Second question is the other way around. Namely, now I have A to X a map F, a map eta. So concentration is on A to X. This eta is fixed. Now suppose A to Y, there is some function is given. Can you have a map down in F at from X to Y? So this is called factoring. So this F is factored through eta. There earlier we had lifting problem, factoring problem. But this actually can be thought of as an extension problem, especially when A to X, this map eta is an inclusion map of topological spaces. Then what is the meaning of having a function A on a subspace? Having a function F at is on the larger space. So eta is the inclusion map. So this is a very special case. So, but the special case name is given to the entire problem. You can say A part is a factorization problem and B part is an inclusion problem. The factorization comes when instead of an inclusion map, you have a surjective map and this is a quotient map. Okay, both these cases are, you can call them as extension problem. Factorization problem is easier, extension problem is difficult, so we will concentrate on extension problem later on. Okay, so factorization problem we will decide very easily this, in this course, that extension problem is the problem. algebraic topology steps in here by bringing a big twist to these questions, which we shall take in the next module. These questions again we will discuss, but with a twist, namely, what is algebraic topology going to do? This is a topological problem, pointed topological problem. Given a subset and a function and a larger space, can you extend the function to the whole space and so on? Okay, it's just a pointed topology problem. So what is algebraic topology doing? That we will discuss in the next session. Thank you.